the U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, standing by our commentators, Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis.
Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis, thrilled to be with you from the broadcast booth. And partner, before we get this thing started, what are you going to be watching?
Who gets off to a fast start? In horse racing terms, they talk about catching a flyer out of the gate. Who sets the pace and makes the other team chase?
And the offense rallies for a first down and 10. Cousins toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Line of scrimmage again to 25, second and 10. A second down throw for Cousins. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Deion Sanders in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. They go play action. Cousins. And he's going to go down again. Reggie White. He's the one to get it this time. And back-to-back Saints are going to bring up a fourth down. Much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And hit it hard, I know it. Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys are tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. Time to establish the run game here early. Some strong running. That one 28 yards on the ground.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to, but they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. A first down throw coming from Vic. Flush to his right. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. And we return, welcoming you back to Minneapolis. All even as we get ready to start the fourth.
Fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
On second down, Vic again. Flushed out right. Room here to run. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I can't express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. If he needs to make those plays with the legs, go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. It's, at this stage of the game, all protections, they're off.
On first and 10, here's Vic. Eluding the pressure right. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. That's second down.
He was able to get away earlier in the drive, but apparently all the time they put in practice finally came to the front, didn't it? They remembered their lessons and found a way to contain him when he took off on that one.
Second down, Vic. He's going to launch this thing way downfield, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Tyreek Hill, 36 yards. And the Rams have broken our tie as they take the lead.
That appeared like any routine NFL quarterback, but it was Michael Vick from the pocket, throws a touchdown pass. I just think about the transformation throughout his career. From Atlanta, where he would take off and go at just about the drop of a hat and turn defenses into mush. And then by the end of his career in Philadelphia, where he completed pass like we just saw from the pocket, yet still had those great legs, when necessary, to help get him out of trouble.
Golden to add the extra point. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Gold now out to kick it away. Stacy Coley on the return. And it'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. Comes Minnesota, and fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted, and we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that, and they've got to make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Breaking the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
They have to like the play call because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
That open man that time, they ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. On second down, Cousins again. From the outside on target to Thielen. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
And they give the mixer to try to pick it up. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be fourth down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading the play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll run with Mixon, going absolutely nowhere. He'll wind up losing a yard or two. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. On first down, it's Gurley. Fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and one. offensively, they